Today I'm going to tell you about gravity. Gravity, from Latin gravitas, meaning weight, or gravitation, is a natural phenomenon by which all things with mass or energy, including planets, stars, galaxies, and even light, are brought toward or gravitated toward one another. On Earth, gravity gives weight to physical objects, and the moon's gravity causes the ocean tides. The force of gravity keeps all of the planets in orbit around the sun. Why do you land on the ground when you jump up instead of flying off into space? Why do things fall down when you throw them or drop them? The answer is a force called gravity, an invisible force that pulls objects towards each other. Earth's gravity is what keeps you on the ground and what makes things fall instead of flying off into outer space. Gravity is very important to us. We could not live on Earth without it. The sun's gravity keeps Earth in orbit around it, keeping us at a comfortable distance to enjoy the sunlight and warmth. Gravity down our atmosphere and the air we need to breathe. Gravity is what holds our world together. Modern work on gravitational theory began with the work of Galileo Galilei in the late 16th and early 17th centuries. In his famous, though possibly apocryphal, experiment dropping balls from the Tower of Pisa and later with careful measurements of balls rolling down inclines, Galileo showed that gravitational acceleration is the same for all objects. This was a major departure from Aristotle's belief that heavier objects have a higher gravitational acceleration. Galileo postulated Earth resistance as the reason the objects with less mass fall more slowly in an atmosphere. Galileo's work set the stage for the formulation of Newton's theory of gravity. Newton's theory enjoyed its greatest success when it was used to predict the existence of Neptune based on motions of Uranus that could not be accounted for by the actions of the other planets. Calculations by both John Couch Adams and Urban Lee Rayer predicted the general position of the planet and Leverrier's calculations of what led Johann Gottfried Galilei to the discovery of Neptune. A discrepancy in Mercury's orbit pointed out flaws in Newton's theory. By the end of the 19th century, it was known that its orbit showed slight perturbations that could not be accounted for entirely under Newton's theory, but also just for another perturbing body, such as a planet orbiting the sun, even closer than Mercury, has been fruitless. The issue was resolved in 1915 by Albert Einstein's new theory of general relativity, which accounted for the small discrepancy in Mercury's orbit. This discrepancy was the advance in the perihelion of Mercury of 42.98 arcseconds per century. In general relativity, the effects of gravitation are ascribed to space-time curative and spherical force. The starting point for general relativity is the equivalence principle, which equates free fall with inertial motion and describes free falling inertial objects as being accelerated relative to non-inertial observers on the ground. In Newtonian physics, however, no such acceleration can occur unless at least one of the objects is being operated on by force. Einstein proposed that space-time is curved by matter and that free-falling objects are moving along locally straight paths in curved space-time. These straight paths are called geodesics. Like Newton's first law of motion, Einstein's theory states that if a force is applied on an object, it would deviate from a geodesic. For instance, we are no longer following geodesics while studying because the mechanical resistance of the Earth exerts an upward force on us, and we are non-inertial on the ground as a result. This explains why moving along the geodesics in space-time is considered inertial. Einstein discovered the field equations of general relativity, which relate the presence of matter and the correlative of space-time and are named after him. According to Newton's third law, the Earth itself experiences a force equal in magnitude and opposite in direction to that which it exerts on a falling object. This means that the Earth also accelerates towards the object until they collide. Because the mass of the Earth is huge, however, the acceleration imparted to the Earth by its opposite force is negligible in comparison to the objects. If the object does not bounce after it has collided with the Earth, each of them then exerts a repulsive contact force on the other, which effectively balances the attractive force of gravity and prevents further acceleration. Since all objects have a gravitational field, you are actually pulling the Earth to you as well. And since Earth is so much larger than you are, you don't really feel it. The application of Newton's law of gravity has enabled the extraction of much of the detailed information we have about the planets in the solar system, the mass of the sun, and details of crustals, even the existence of dark matter is inferred using Newton's law of gravity. Although we have not traveled to all the planets nor to the sun, we know the masses. These masses are obtained by applying the laws of gravity to the measured characteristics of the orbit. The space in the orbit maintains its orbit because of the force of gravity acting upon it. Planets orbit stars orbit galactic centers, galaxies orbit a center of mass and clusters orbit as superclusters. The force of gravity exerted on one object by another is directly proportional to the product of those objects' masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. The earliest gravity, possibly in the form of quantum gravity, supergravity, or gravitational singularity, along with ordinary space and time, developed during the Planck epoch, up to 10 or 43 seconds after the birth of the universe, possibly from a primordial state such as a false vacuum, quantum vacuum, or virtual particle, in a currently unknown manner. In classical theories of gravitation, the changes in the gravitational field propagate. A change in the distribution of energy and momentum of matter results in subsequent alteration in the distance of the gravitational field, which it reduces. In a relativistic sense, the speed of gravity refers to the speed of a gravitational wave, which, as predicted by general relativity and confirmed by observation of the GW170817 neutron star measure, is the same speed as the speed of light. Thanks for watching this Adventurous Kids episode.